Hello, everyone. My name is Adam, and welcome back to Plip Plop. All right, does it even need to be said? You know why you're here. We're back with more Choosing Beggars content, of course. Once again, if you are new here or just haven't subscribed yet, please consider subscribing. It will absolutely make my day. All right, let's get started. Chick-fil-A store asks for volunteers to work for chicken, not money. So we don't really have to go into the post. It's kind of self-explanatory, but I did want to show this one for the comment. Me goes at gas station to refill cashier, cash or credit card. Me, chicken. Ain't how it works. And very insulting that they would even consider that as an option, but okay. Okay, this one seems like a pretty long post, but let's see what we got here. Hello, fellow moms. Apparently, I have to make yet another post needing childcare. I get that we are coming out of COVID from 1.5 years of being shut down and not bringing home funds, but that doesn't mean all of us hardworking parents can afford these ridiculous prices thrown at us. A lot of daycare facilities charge, I can't read the number, a week. I had my child at the best, quote unquote, blank, and was charged that. The reasoning they are allowed to charge more is number one, and the only factor is they actually have taxes taken out. Yeah, Uncle Sam, aka the government, aka IRS, gets their cut. Number two, factoring is they undergo specific schooling requirements that the government oversees, and their facilities are under government control, which means they do regular checks for health and safety standards. Now, about me and why I won't pay a ridiculous charge to have my child watched. One, I work in a warehouse building, busting my ass in a building, I said building twice, that is actually factually proven to be 20 plus degrees hotter inside than it is outside on any day. Two, I am walking my ass 2+ miles a day and lifting up to 50 pounds by myself on ladders and such. Three, I am pulled 100 different directions, but I can still answer who, what, when, why, and any other type of question there is without giving attitude at any given moment. And I also catch hell for other people's fuck-ups, because that's part of my job. Four, I have to drive 1 hour one way to get to my job from my home. Five, despite most companies paying $3 more for my specific job title, I actually like my company and my job and my coworkers, so even though I make a whole $17 per hour, doesn't mean I'm going to up and quit right now. Six, I private pay for everything, meaning no government assistance, no funds from baby daddy, no funds from family. Seven, gas prices. Enough said. So unless Big Brother, aka the government, has legal control over what you do in your home concerning kids, then you have not earned that ridiculous price tag. Now that I gave out my 2 cents, here's the other part of me. I'm a mostly easygoing single parent of a beautiful, easygoing, hardly fussy 8-month-old girl. I work as an inventory specialist, aka material handler, aka shipping and receiving clerk, aka inventory clerk for a Fortune 500 company in the East End of blank. I am a cat-friendly household with one foster fail, a feral colony mama turned into my fur baby, and a foster who is available for adoption. PM me for details if interested. I have done this parenting thing solo, meaning no funds, no physical assistance from anyone, and who has been successful until I went out on an extensive medical leave in which under my paid for private health insurance, I received short-term disability at 60% pay rate. My time off work was exclusively about my daughter and her health needs. I have yet to even get started on my own health needs because, again, Uncle Sam and ridiculous prices. I do not go out and party, nor hang out with friends, nor blow my money on anything for myself. My money goes to bills, debt payoffs, and then mostly to get my child everything she needs with a few wants that are pre-used items, and of course the necessities for my cats. I have plans to get back into a college to get a diploma or certificate to better myself in life for my child, so eventually about 2 years from now or so I'll be hopefully be able to afford more because I make a lot more money. As for what I'm looking for is someone who has been in my shoes, who has rode the struggle bus, who is humble to be a caregiver for my child so I can go work my ass off for corporate America to make someone else rich. I'm looking for someone who will appreciate the extra income I can provide them each week, preferably through Cash App or Zelle for receipt copies, but I am willing to do cash payments if you sign receipts showing you are indeed paid in full. I can afford approximately $100 to $130 weekly. I work Monday through Friday right now, 7 a.m. to 3:30 p.m., so the times needed will depend on your proximity to my home in Hillview or my job off Blankenbaker Parkway. I am looking for someone who's reliable, consistent, compassionate, and empathetic. I do require you to be fully vaccinated against the situation, plus all regular vaccines required in a childhood and the flu vax, or you're going to be able to wear a mask and non-latex gloves in all times. No exceptions. I don't have much of a preference. Oh my God. I don't have much of a preference in my home of yours. So as long as there's cameras installed in case of injury or serious illness, in the event of an accident or illness, or someone who is CPR AED certified, or someone who can administer proper immediate treatment, once treatment has been administered, then you understand you are to notify me immediately, no exceptions. Please comment, message if you have read, agree, and fully comprehend this post. Thank you for your time. Bruh. That was painful to read for many reasons. This is a very bitter person who's angry at the government, angry at the world, but also wants someone who is willing to struggle as well and be paid $100 a week. Okay, here we have a Craigslist post. Film crew needed for feature film project. Right at the top, non-paid gig. Please do not apply if you are seeking monetary compensation. So they're basically looking to fill all of these roles: camera crew, makeup artist, production assistants, editor, storyboard illustrator slash sketch artist. And it appears that that's it. But what bothers me about posts like this is if you were to flip this into another field, like, you know, something in engineering or oil or something like that, and you just rattled off 10 different roles that are required for that field, people would look at you like you are insane. Yet in the creative world, there's this weird thought that you can just do this because people are passionate about it. It's like, no, they need money. You can't have an entire film crew just appear because they're passionate and work for you for free. Absolutely insane. Apologies, rant over. Hi there. As an influencer of tech products slash gadgets, reviewing all types of technology for my YouTube channel, covering over 100,000 views on each video, is there any chance I can test this product as requested by my viewers? Hi. Just buy it then? It's £8. Regards, Chris. However, in return, you'll more likely see a big increase in sales, as I'll link this product to the description of my YouTube channel and see a massive turnover in revenue if purchasing. I'm basically giving you free customers. It's nice to do a favor for each other. I'll profit off the video, and so will you. No thanks. Like, we've seen stuff like this before for really maybe high-end gaming products, like mechanical keyboards and stuff like that, where it's at least somewhat understandable from a monetary standpoint, but this is £8. It's a budget gaming keyboard, and you're asking for it for free. Come on. I'll take them off your hands right now. Just give me a good price, man. I did give you a good price. I'm in no rush to sell. Oh, but I'm in a rush to buy. Just saw one that was for PS4, but I have an Xbox, so now, you know, I kind of want one. I'm like a person who sees something and they want it that exact same day, you know? Gotcha. Well, it's yours for $110 tomorrow. Listen, Blank, I'm a teen who likes to game. Wouldn't it just make your day giving a kid a good price on it so that you'll know he'll enjoy it? What would you consider a good price? Let's see here, Blank. How about $60, 50% teen discount? Dude, GTFO, bye. I love that you left the group at the bottom. Okay, the way this is written does not seem like a quote-unquote teen who likes to game wrote this. Like, it seems like a full-ass adult is just trying to haggle. This is very much how do you do fellow kids vibes. I think we'll end it there, so thank you all so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please consider giving it a like or letting us know in the comment section down below. And as I said at the beginning, if you haven't subscribed yet, please consider subscribing. It really helps out. Thanks again for sticking around, and we'll see you in the next one.